My name is Kyriakos Kouroussis. I'm a senior academic in the School of Engineering. My expertise is in aeronautical engineering. I conduct research, I teach, and I lead the university programs in airworthiness, engineering, and aircraft maintenance. As engineers, we tend to think that getting better technology can help us achieve better safety. And this is partly true. Effectively, we regulate every aspect of aviation, and today we're able to predict how reliable an aircraft can be. But can we say the same for the human? Can we reliably predict how a human will perform in an actual workplace? If we would like to see how we perform, how we operate in aviation, we'll see that we have a set of actions we can define as standard practice. However, there is a certain element, a certain percentage of actions which can be categorized as deviations. And this is where creativity gets into the play. People can be creative. And creativity is not something that we want in aviation. Effectively, we have a creative solution, this can be a source of a problem. There are different ways that people can either bypass or can violate barriers. And this is when accidents actually occur. But what happens when a design does not work well in real life? Let's see an example. An aircraft losing one of its engine doors during flight is not a pleasant situation. Fortunately, in most cases, this does not lead to substantial damage or to an accident. However, if the same problem runs over a period of 20 years, this is something that we'd like to look more into detail. Close to 40 events over that period, and an accident where an aircraft has lost one of its engines is definitely something that would make us think more. How can this happen so many times? Looking at the accident investigation report, the cause may seem apparent. A technician who forgets to close one of the doors. But is this really the case? We have to go back to day one, or even day zero, on the drawing board of an aeronautical engineer. One of the requirements that we need to meet as part of the design is to design for maintainability. In this aircraft type, that we will call aircraft A, the locking of the door that has to happen on the lower part of the engine nacelles. This requires the maintenance technician to perform a task in a confined space, which can be very challenging, especially when you have a person working under time pressure. And this is the reason why aeronautical engineers use standards for ergonomic design when they try to allow for enough space, enough clearance for the technicians to work on aircraft. And these standards have to be utilized in conjunction with past experience from other designs, but also past experience from in-service aircraft. And this very close to the ground position of the latches brings another problem. It practically affects both the maintainability and the inspectability of this critical section of the aircraft. Let's do a comparison with aircraft B. This is a similar aircraft for a similar role, which does not experience the same issue as aircraft A. If we look at the bottom side of the engine nacelles, we will see clearly the relative position of the latches. In aircraft B, the latches are further away from the nacelle center line. This design variation in aircraft B is instrumental both for maintainability and inspectability purposes. It gives easier access to the technicians, but at the same time, it gives easier observation to the inspecting staff. This design feature in aircraft B makes it trouble-free, and this is proven by in-service experience. A design flaw that we do today may haunt us for 20 years or more. And these kind of flaws are the source of deviations, and they can be a real threat for the safe operation of aircraft. However, design flaws are not easy to fix in aviation. And the reason is that this industry operates under a very small profit margin. Effectively, design changes are put into scrutiny. We need to do a change if this solves an existing safety problem. And an effective aeronautical engineer is that who takes into account both the needs of the machine and the human who is going to operate the aircraft. You're most welcome to contact me if you would like to learn more about what we do in aeronautical engineering at the University of Limerick.